So please welcome Denver Broncos superstar, Brandon Marshall.
Cimarron Memorial High School class of 2016. Sorry, this is kind of low. Keep good men company, and now we'll become one of them. Distinguished guests, administration, faculty, staff, friends, and you, the class of 2016. It is an honor for me to be this year's 2016 commencement speaker. Thank you to all of those in the front and behind the scenes for this honor. I would be remiss if I didn't thank my number one and two supporters, my mother and my brother, for their unselfish love and support. Thank you. To all the moms, grandmas, aunties, dads, granddads, uncles, and guardians, stand up. We salute you. This diploma is for you. As you know, I'm a class of 2007 Spartan. Once a Spartan, always a Spartan. It seems like yesterday I walked those halls running from class to class, begging and pleading not to be marked tardy. I've been there. But the dedication, determination, and discipline, I'm here to tell you, it paid off. Class of 2016, you're about to embark on your biggest challenge of life. It's called life. You stood on the shoulders of mom, dad, grandma, grandpa, an aunt, an uncle, a sister, a brother. It is because of them you can now live the dream. Dream big, I did. But keep your focus small, all the little things matter. So set goals, make wise choices. Find your passion, be determined, and respect everyone. Remain humble to all of those who came early and stayed late. To all of those who stood the test when failing wasn't an option. To all of those who wouldn't allow proficiency tests to become an obstacle and defeated the odds. And then to those of you who are sitting there saying, "Woo, I made it." It's a beautiful day for you. One thing we all have in common in life is that we all will face adversity. We all will face hurdles that we will either decide to jump over or run around. The choice is yours. You know I'm a Super Bowl champion, right? Well, I guarantee you, I wouldn't have been if I would have listened to my critics. I've had my own hurdles that I faced in my professional career. In 2012, my rookie year, I was drafted to the Jacksonville Jaguars in the fifth round. I thought it was gonna be an easy transition for me, but I was wrong. I ended up being cut three times, twice in 1 week, actually. I'll never forget, my linebacker actually told me, he said he didn't think I was cut out for the NFL. At that moment, I wanted to cuss him smooth out. But I took a different approach. I used it to fuel my fire. I worked harder than ever, and it was now the biggest chip out of the many that I had on my shoulder. I let that fuel me, and in 2013, I was blessed enough to get picked up by the Denver Broncos. I ended up working my tail off for 16 weeks on the practice squad before I actually got called up to play on the active roster. And to make things better, I got the call on Christmas Eve. That was the best Christmas gift I've ever gotten. In 2014, I started and led the team of tackles. And in 2015, I was second on the team of tackles and led my team to a victory in the biggest game in all sports, the Super Bowl. So the message is clear. It's not if, but when you will face your hurdles in life. No matter how high it may seem or how defeated you may feel, if you believe and if you push through that tired and defeated feeling, you will jump over any hurdle that you may come across, and I guarantee you that you will become the most successful you that you can be. Congratulations, class of 2016.